वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, माई सेल्फ पल्लवी आनंद. सो टुडे वी आर इन अ सेशन ऑफ क्लास 7 बायोलॉजी लेसन 2 न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स एंड ह्यूमन बींग्स. सो एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सो मेनी टॉपिक्स इन अ प्रीवियस पार्ट इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो, व्हाट अबाउट द न्यूट्रिशन, टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन, व्हाट अबाउट द टाइप ऑफ टीथ एंड how many teeth, incisor, dentine, canine, molars, premolars, everything we have discussed in the previous part. So today we are going to discuss about the digestive system in human beings. So slowly we are going to discuss about the portion, about the organ that involved in our digestion. As we have discussed before, how we intake the food, injection, then digestion, then absorption, then assimilation and ejection. Hopefully you remember that. Today we will just sort it out one by one, because that words are typical, so we will discuss in a local words. So first of all, it is very clear that as we take in the food, it is not break down or it is not come out from our body in the same portion, isn't it? So the when we intake the food break down into simple and soluble molecules. Simple and soluble molecules. For the digestion of food, two things help us. First, the main part, main organs, and second one is the supportive organs, as salivary gland, pancreatic gland, then gastric glands. These are the supportive organs which help in the process of digestion. The second point which we are going to discuss is the our digestion start from the mouth itself. As we intake our food, our digestion start from that very portion. So you can find it out here. Your tongue, we should discuss some part of a tongue also. That you just go to your textbook, there you will find the portion of a tongue where we can feel salt, bitter and sugar. Taste buds are available in our tongue. We will discuss it later. So our digestion start from mouth, and as we intake our food, our digestion start from the mouth. Here our food break down into the smaller molecules, smaller particles with the help of teeth. Our teeth helps to break down the food into the simple and soluble particles. There the our salivary gland present in our mouth secretes saliva which mix with our food and make the food in a paste form, in a slippery form, which help the food to slip from the mouth to through the oesophagus till stomach. So what is the use of saliva? Saliva mix with our food and make the food slippery and in a paste form, which help in the digestion. So here mouth, you can see this is a mouth. In a buccal cavity, our food mix with the saliva and break down with the help of teeth and passes from the mouth to the stomach. In between there is a osteophagus, which is a muscular structure. Osteophagus is a muscular structure, or you can say food pipe is a muscular structure which contract and relax. Contraction and relaxation of muscles help the food to pass from mouth to the stomach. The way food comes from mouth to the stomach is osteophagus. That is osteophagus, or you can say food pipe as well. Here this, you can find it out, it is a muscular structure. This one is a muscular structure which relax and contract. Contraction and relaxation of muscles take place there, which help the food to push downward. Okay, so by the process, food transfer from mouth with the mix up with the saliva and break down with the help of teeth and pass to the stomach. Now our food, which food? The breakdown food. The simple molecules of food reach to the stomach portion. Where the simple food breakdown of the food reach? It. Now our food is in our stomach. In stomach, the process continue for 2 to 4 hours. The food stomach for 2 to 4 hours. Stomach is a J shape, J for jug. Our stomach is a J-shaped bag present near the below the osteophagus, where food reach after the mixing with saliva and after the breakdown into the simple particles. There, in the small intestine, our food get more digested by the help of gastric gland. In stomach, the gastric glands are present, which secrete mucus, hydrochloric acid, and gastric juice. In stomach, mucus, hydrochloric acid, and gastric juice are secreted, which help the process of digestion. Mucus help our food to be sticky, to be moving down. Hydrochloric acid, which is secreted in our stomach, help to kill all the bacteria or some germs which enter in our food, that is being killed by the hydrochloric acid in our stomach, secreted by the gastric gland. Okay, after the stomach, the food is being transferred to the small intestine. You can find it here. Small intestine is the longest part of our digestive system. It is around 7.5 meter. It is in a coiled shape. Just look here. This one is our small intestine, and it is in a coiled shape, and it is about 7.5 meter long. It is coiled and adjusted between the large intestine. It is coiled and arranged between the large intestine, where the food are transferred from the stomach to, when the food are being transferred from the small intestine, from the stomach to the small intestine. In small intestine, the process of digestion almost completed. In the small portion of small intestine, all the process of digestion complete here, and the process is done, absorption is also done in the small intestine. As we have discussed in a previous video, what is absorption, what is assimilation. So absorption of food, absorption of energy, absorption is done in the small intestine. And in the small intestine, there is a finger-like projection present, that is villi. In small intestine, there is a finger-like projection present, that is villi, which help in the passes of food and which help in the absorption of food. It is villi is present in a small intestine, and it is a finger-like projection. Now, our food is completely digested here with the help of some juice which is secreted in our small intestine. So, in our small intestine, there is pancreatic juice. That is pancreatic juice which is secreted by the pancreas. In small intestine, our digestion completes, almost complete. And with the help of pancreatic juice which is secreted from the pancreas, and the bile juice which is secreted from the liver. Bile juice is secreted from the liver, and pancreatic juice is secreted by the pancreas. In the small intestine, bile juice is secreted with the liver and is being stored in our gallbladder. This bile juice is being secreted by the liver and being stored in the gallbladder. When the food reaches to the small intestine after the process of absorption through villi, the food is being transferred. The food, undigested food. Now that food particles become undigested food because almost the digestion completed in a small intestine. And now what is left over, what is not being digested, that are undigested food, which is transferred to the large intestine. After the digestion completes in a small intestine, the leftover food or the undigested food is transferred to the large intestine.
You can find it out here. This one is a large intestine. This is around 1.5 meter long. Large intestine is around 1.5 meter long. What is the function of large intestine? Large intestine absorbs the excess water in the food. As the food transfer from the small intestine, undigested food, here what large intestine do? Large intestine absorb the extra water, excessive water and salt, whatever the waste, from the waste. What is the function of large intestine? Taking the best out of waste. So it takes the excessive water and certain salts available in a food, undigested food. It take it out from there and transfer to the anus for the discharge, for the ejection. The word ejection we have discussed in our previous video. You remember the thrown out of undigestion, digested food from our body is ejection. So after the absorption of water, the food is transferred to the anus and then it is passed out by our body in a form of fecus or stool. That is the digestion completed here, and our body after 2-3 hours again ready for the another intake of food. Hopefully you understand up to here. Thank you for today. Stay safe.